In the previous videos in this series, we focused on applying and editing pre-installed masks in PaintShop Pro. In this video, we'll go over how to create several types of masks from scratch. Before we get started, if you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on Corel's Discovery Center. Here you can also download a written copy of this tutorial, along with sample images you can download to try out the steps yourself. I'll start with this image, which has a photo layer above a solid filled layer. The photo layer is active so that masks will be applied to that layer. If I click the New Mask Layer icon in the Layers palette, here are my options. These same options are also available in the Layers New Mask Layer menu. Hide All and Show All are pretty straightforward. If I create a Hide All mask, a black mask is added above the photo, blocking the entire photo. If I activate the paintbrush and switch the color to white, I can uncover what I want to show. This particular brush has a very low hardness, which produces the blurring around the edges. Now I'll undo and apply a Show All mask. This mask is, of course, white, and I can paint with black over what I want to cover. Or, instead of black, I can choose a gray color and do some partial blocking. The next two options are Hide and Show Selection, which are relevant when I have something selected. To demonstrate this, I'll activate the Freehand Selection tool and trace around the frog. If I choose Hide Selection, that area gets blocked, and I can now place part of another photo in this blocked area. Show Selection does the opposite, blocking everything except what's inside. For a more exact selection, I can use the Smart Selection brush. With the mode set to Add and a medium tolerance, I can click around the frog to eventually select the whole thing. After applying the Show Selection mask, only the frog remains. The rest of the image could be used for things like captions or for other creatures. The last New Mask option is From Image. All I need in order to use From Image is to have my mask image open while I'm working. As a first example, I'll bring in this grayscale image of a border. With my frog image selected and the photo layer still active, I'll choose From Image. I'll select the correct image as the source and use the default Source Luminance option. Here is the result. The outer parts of the photo are blocked, with some bits of partial transparency closer in. The mask image stretches or contracts to fit its photo, so be careful to choose an image that has about the same aspect ratio as your photo. Another From Image option is Any Non-Zero Value. This means that no shades of gray from the mask image will be applied. All pixels will be converted to either black or white. This means there's no partial transparency once the mask is applied. To demonstrate the Source Opacity option, I'll use this image as the mask. I want to remove all parts of the white background to make the entire background transparent. So I'll activate the background eraser, change sampling to once, and set limits to contiguous. I'll start by clicking on a white pixel, then drag around the rest of the image to erase all of the white. Back to my frog, I'll first apply this image using Source Luminance. If I apply the frame image as is, the transparent parts of the frame image will be blocked on the photo, which will block the frog. So I'll click Invert Mask Data. This is the result. The transparent parts of the frame image remain on the photo, and the leaves are blocked according to the grayscale equivalence of their various colors. If I apply the same image using Source Opacity, the result is that transparent areas fully remain on the photo, and any opaque part of the frame, including all of the leaves of all colors, become blocked. Mask layers can be adjusted just like any other layer. The image I'll apply this time as a mask is this leafy texture. When applying it to the frog, I'll keep the mask data inverted so that the lighter areas of the leaves will become blocked. This produces a blue leaf effect throughout, and the frog appears to be peeking through the leaves. To adjust the mask, I'll first select its layer. I can reduce its opacity to bring out more of the photo. Or I can try some of the options in the Adjust menu. Anything that works on grayscale images will have an effect. For example, I'll try Brightness and Contrast. Moving both of these sliders makes significant changes. Or I can try Fill Light and Clarity to mute the leaves a bit. I can use Gaussian blur to make the leaves more fuzzy. Or I can add some noise for a pixelated effect. This brings us to the end of this tutorial on creating your own masks. If you've been watching this video on YouTube, please follow the link in the description below, which will take you to this tutorial page in Corel's Discovery Center. Here you'll find a written version of this tutorial, along with sample images you can download and follow along.